Hello students, as you know, due to the coronavirus, our school is closed. So we are going to introduce online smart classes for you. These classes are very important to improve your basic concept. Today I am going to explain chapter 12 from class 10 science books. It is the part of the physics. In class 10 and chapter 12, there is a chapter which is known as magnetism. As you know, in previous classes, electric charge and types of electric charge. So there are two types of electric charge, positive and negative. Now, electricity, it is also divided into two parts. First one, static electricity, and second one, current electricity. In static electricity, we will discuss charge at rest. But in current electricity, we will discuss the motion of the charge through the conductor. So, in class 10, the first topic is electric current. Electric current, whenever current, electric charge will flow through the conductor, then it is known as electric current. Mathematically, it is denoted by R is equal to Q divided by T, where Q charge flowing through the conductor and T time taken. So we can say the rate of flow of electric charge through a conductor is called electric current. This is an expression we can give electric current. Now we can find out assignment of electric current. It is Coulomb per second, known as ampere, and denoted by capital A. Now we can define 1 ampere electric current. So to define 1 ampere electric current, if the value of Q is 1 coulomb and time is 1 second, then we can see the current flowing through the conductor will be 1 coulomb per second, which is equivalent to 1 ampere. So current flowing through the conductor is said to be 1 ampere if 1 coulomb of charge is flowing through the conductor in 1 second. Remember, electric current is a scalar current. Now, second topic from this chapter is electric circuit. Electric circuit, it is the path followed by the electric current. Or we can see the path followed by the electric current represented by electric circuit. I am going to draw a simple electric circuit having a battery, ammeter, bulb, and switch. As we understand, the electric current will follow the path denoted by arrow, so this whole arrangement goes as electric circuit. Now, next topic in class 10 is symbols of electrical components used in electrical circuit. So, symbols are first one, resistor. A resistor, it is drawn by magnet. Whenever you see this symbol in electric circuit, it will resistance or resistor. Second one, resistance. It is also known as variable resistance and drawn as magnet or maybe sometimes. It is brightness and the symbol written is R. The next symbol which is used in electrical circuit is cell. So this is the symbol for the cell. This is positive, this is negative. Next one, battery. This is the combination of cells. Whenever more than two cells are connected in series, then that combination is known as battery. The next symbol, wire, joint. It is given by light. Next one, crossing of wire. It is given by light. The next one, which is electric bulb, it is drawn like that, then open stretch, that should be paragraph, then close stretch, then the meter curve. Then after that, ammeter, a device which is used to measure electric current load as ammeter, this is the same. Then voltmeter, a device which is used to measure potential difference, it is given by this symbol. And finally, there is a galvanometer, which is used to detect electric current in a circuit. So these are the basic symbols are used in electric circuit. The next topic from class 10, in chapter 12, is electric potential. Electric potential. So electric potential is defined as the amount of work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to given point in electric field. It is denoted by V. So if the amount of work done to move a given charge Q from infinity to given point is W, then electric potential at that point is written by W divided by Q. Now using this equation, we can calculate the electric potential, and we can also find all its assignment. This is Zoom formula equivalent to Mho and denoted by capital V. We can also define 1 Mho electric potential. If in this relation the value of W is 1 Joule and the value of Q is 1 Coulomb, then we can define 1 Mho as if the amount of work done to move 1 Coulomb of charge from infinity to given point in electric field is 1 Joule, then the electric potential at that point will be 1 Mho. This is the derivation of 1 Mho. The next topic, which is also very similar to electric potential, that is electric potential difference. Electric potential difference, that is the amount of work done to move unit positive charge from one point to another point in electric field. This is only the difference between electric potential and electric potential difference. In electric potential, the amount of work done to move unit positive charge from infinity to given point. But in the definition of electric potential difference, there is the amount of work done to move unit positive charge from one point to another point in electric field. So we are going to find out an expression for electric potential difference, which can be also denoted by V. So here, W, that is the amount of work done to move unit positive charge from point B to A, then it is divided by charge. If charge is given, then there is only the work done with the difference, which will represent potential difference. So assignment of potential difference is also Joule per coulomb, which is equivalent to Mho. Now we can define 1 Mho potential difference. So if the amount of work done to move 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point in electric field is 1 Joule, then the electric potential difference between these two points will be also 1 volt. This is the derivation of 1 volt. Now next topic from this chapter is Ohm's law. Remember, it is very very important in class 10. According to Ohm's law, if the physical conditions of the conductor remain constant, then the current flowing through it is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across to the conductor. Mathematically, we can write V directly proportional to R. V is the potential difference applied across to the conductor, and R is the current flowing through the conductor. So this is the mathematical form of Ohm's law. As we know that when we put the sign of the proportional, here is the constant, here the constant is R, known as resistance of the conductor. R here, resistance of the conductor. So this is the mathematical form of Ohm's law. We can also define R using this equation. R is equal to V divided by L. We will discuss resistance in the next. So this is Ohm's law. Now the experimental verification of Ohm's law. We can draw a simple circuit which is given by the diagram. There is a battery. There is resistor by which we can change the value of the current. After changing the value of the resistor, ammeter is also there to measure electric current. A conductor across this we will apply a voltmeter to measure the potential difference. So the circuit which is used for the experimental verification of Ohm's law will be according to this diagram. We can verify Ohm's law using this circuit in lab. For example, applied potential difference is 1 volt and current flowing through the conductor is 1 ampere. Similarly, when we apply 2 volt, current will be 2 ampere, 3 volt, current will be 3 ampere. So, in this way, we are able to find out ratio of V and I. So, V, I in this set, it is 1, in this set, it is 1, and in last set, it is also. It means the ratio between V and I will be constant. And we can say the resistance of the conductor will be constant. If we get a constant value of the resistance of the conductor in this experiment, then the Ohm's law will be verified. We can also plot the graph between V and I to verify the Ohm's law. V either on the y axis and I either on the x axis. And if we plot the graph between V and I, that should be a straight line. If we get a straight line, then the Ohm's law will be verified. This is the experimental verification of Ohm's law. Now, next topic, resistance or the resistance of the conductor. So, as we know that whenever the current will flow through a conductor, there is the opposition by the conductor to flow of the current. And this ability of the conductor to oppose the flow of the current to the conductor is known as resistance of the conductor. Mathematically, as we know that from the Ohm's law, R is equal to V divided by R. So we can say mathematically the ratio between the potential difference and the electric current flowing through the conductor is called resistance. Using this relation, we can find out the SI unit of resistance, which is volt or ampere equivalent to Ohm. And the symbol of the Ohm used in omega, it is omega, it is used to provide the symbols of the Ohm, which is the SI unit of the resistance. Now we can define 1 volt. If 1 volt potential difference is applied across to the conductor and current flowing through the conductor is 1 ampere, then the resistance of the conductor will be 1. In next topic, we will discuss factors on which resistance of conductor depends. So there are 4 factors. First factor, length. Resistance of conductor is directly proportional to length of the conductor. It means as we increase the length, the resistance of the conductor will be also increased in the same ratio. If we increase length 2 times, then the resistance will be also 2 times. The second, resistance of conductor inversely proportional to the area of the cross section of the conductor. It means as we increase the area of the cross section of the conductor, its resistance will decrease. If we just double the area of cross section, the resistance will be half. The third factor, which is temperature, it is another important factor on which the resistance of the conductor depends. As we increase the temperature, the resistance of the conductor will also increase. Now, finally, there is one more factor, nature of conductor. So, resistance of the conductor is also depend on the nature of the conductor. For the different material of the conductor having equal length and area of cross section, their resistance will be different. So these are 4 factors for which resistance of conductor depends. Now next topic, specific resistance. Explain specific resistance, we will use mathematical relation previously given. As we know that R directly proportional to L and R inversely proportional to T. As we combine both the relations, we can write R directly proportional to L divided by. Now, as we root the sign of the proportionality, we will use a constant rho This is known as the specific resistance of the conductor. So we can write R is equal to rho L divided by. Now there is an expression part of it is R A divided by. Using this relation, we can define resistivity or the specific resistance of the conductor. Remember, it is also known as resistivity. From this relation, if A is equal to unit and L is equal to unit, then we get rho is equal to R. It means now we can define resistivity of the conductor in terms of the resistivity. So the definition is the resistance of unit area of cross section and unit length of the conductor known as resistivity of the material of that conductor. Now we can write down the SI unit of the resistivity from this relation. Rho is equal to ohm meter square divided by meter. So the SI unit is ohm meter. It is the SI unit for the resistivity. Now the classification of the different material on the basis of the resistivity. So there are conductors, all the conductors having low value of the resistivity. So we can say when the material has low value of the resistivity, then that will be a good conductor. For the insulator, the resistivity, there is a very high value of resistivity, so we cannot conduct charge through that. Now next topic. System of resistors, or we can say combination of the resistors. So given the resistor, so this topic we will discuss in the next video.